G'day, I'm Sean, and welcome to Blade Mate Lawn Care. Well, this one looks pretty tough, ladies and gents. I'm definitely not going to get it all done today. The old saying, how do you eat an elephant? One bite at a time. Let's eat this elephant one bite at a time, shall we? So we're going to start over here, just this end. So the first thing I need to do is just tidy some of this stuff up. I'm going to get all the tires and make a pole there. I'm just going to clear that out with a whippersnipper a bit first. I'll find a spot for the kayaks and then just start going through. The plan is, there is no plan, so make up a plan when you get there, and that's the plan. Thank you. That's filled with water. It's gone all through the inside. So I'm just gonna leave it there to drain for a little while, and then I'll stack it neatly over here with the other one. Okie doke, we're making a little bit of progress. I just need to make a neat spot to place stuff like this. So I'm just gonna go whip through here, rake it out, and then just lean everything up there nicely. I'm not getting rid of all this stuff. Okay, not bad. Let's have a look at the other side. Go. Now I did consider leaving this here just because it's got some lovely flowers, you know, good for the bees and all that sort of stuff. However, there's lots of vines coming over, and all this is going to do is contribute to the fence buckling a decade sooner than it otherwise would, unless I clear all this off. Thank goodness no one's home. That would have been a rude surprise, I think. Okay, so we have a marked improvement already. Still got a long way to go. And we're about four hours into this job. And we've only achieved this bit here, but I'm pretty proud of the effort so far. This was quite a bit of work involved in just clearing this small part here. Well, let's see how far backwards this driveway goes. I reckon it'll come to around here somewhere and maybe link up with a path that goes down there, but we'll get to that in due time. Thank you. today I'm going to try and get to the fence. Probably keep into the left of this car, which is straight down in line with the house. So the plan for today is to just get into it. It looks like a mattress there. They do curbside pickups here for bulky items, so I'm going to drag that out the front, and any other big stuff that I find in here that shouldn't be there, I will also put out the front. Any small stuff that I can get rid of, I'll just load it on my trailer and get rid of it. This is my walk behind string trimmer. It's got a little ball thing on there, I'll show you. And it just kind of slides along on that ball. quite a number of wasps. Those are European wasps, so they're introduced, they're a pest. I have no problem spraying them. In the meantime though, I'm gonna go ahead here and just get started peeling this back across the fence. I explained in part one that the reason I'm cutting it down instead of leaving it there, you know, because it has all the lovely flowers and stuff, is just for the longevity of the fence, which will undoubtedly eventually buckle over from the weight of all that, so I'm gonna cut it down. Bigger than the one I found yesterday. Once again, I'm lucky now on my time. That could have been awful.
Yeah.
What a mad game. Probably as good a time as any to call it there for the day. So that was definitely one of the worst experiences of my life. Look, when you're in this job, every now and then you get sprayed with a little bit of dog poo. That's not what just happened to me. I've encountered a couple of freshly dead and a couple of slightly decomposing either mice or rats. I think they're rats. There's a bit of farmland over there. And I smelled it before I saw it. But what happened is, as just as I was trimming just down here a moment ago, pretty sure I got a decomposing rat with my whippersnipper, and you better believe I felt its rotten areas splash across my face. So yeah, it was pretty bad. I just had to race over to the tap and had my face under there. Can't taste it anymore though. That's always a plus. Not as much junk to haul away today. That's that bin full of rubbish. I'll bring the bin back. Decent chunk of green waste over here. had to put the bag in the back, squeeze it in there behind the mower. It's too heavy, too full, and I'm closer to 40 than 30 now, so I'm not risking an injury just to put a bag on a ute. So I've just been to the tip, dropped off that grass, and went for a bit of a storm. Looks like I finished just in time. A little bit of roadworks going on, that's why I'm sitting here. But wow, it's very loud right now. This will make life easier.
Here's what we're up to.
Thank you.
so I am making an executive decision under here.
I don't know what it is. Tarp with rubbish, pretty sure. I don't think anyone's going to hold it against me at this stage if I do not get all this out.
I'll just whip around it and leave that there. The clients will be able to sort that out.
Thank you.
closer to the finish line. A little bit of rubbish to collect around here. Obviously I've got to go over the whole yard several times with the catcher on just to tidy it up. Now, just noting the amount of rubbish scattered through the yard, I'll actually have to dump this in the landfill, not the green waste area, just because I'm not going to go through and sift through all that. I'll just catch it with the mower and yeah. Okay, so here we are back again. This is all we have left. Going to go over a bunch of times, collect the clippings, just do a quick little tidy up around here, and then give that a pressure wash, and that's game. And we'll be able to say goodbye to this place. this one was going to be an epic. Now you saw this yard, there's still going to be, you know, little bits of plastic and rubbish and all that sort of stuff. It'll rise to the top as the grass breaks down. I think maybe I scratched the surface a little bit. Could be here for a week going over it and scraping through that to get everything out. I'm limited by the time that I have, so I'm not too concerned if there's one or two little spots that aren't 100%. I'm proud of my effort, so let's have a look around.